Hey everybody, today we're going to take a look at this, the Eleaf iStick TC-100W temperature control box mod, right here on my vaping place. Hey everybody, how you doing? Nice of you to join me today. Thanks for coming. First off, I want to apologize to everyone out there. This review has been a long time coming. Between a lot of personal things with work and family, and then with the deeming regulations coming out from the FDA, I have been in a rather large tailspin funk, whatever you want to call it, for the last few weeks. I know I should have gotten it out, but I haven't. And one of the reasons is how I've been trying to figure out how exactly to go about doing this review. Do I do the review like I normally would with the unboxing and the way everybody else does, with the up close and with showing you how the menus and all that stuff works? Or do I just give you my personal views on what this mod is, what I found good with it, what I found bad with it, what I found mezza with, okay? Well, after doing a lot of thinking and a lot of soul searching, I've come up with a way of talking about this mod, okay? First off, right off the bat, I'm going to tell you I really, really like this mod. I really do. It's got all of the features and everything else that I like. I was looking for when I went out looking for a mod. It's also got a couple of things about it that really kind of drive me nuts. But, you know, that's my personal take on it. You may not find some of the things that I've found on this thing to be quite as much of an issue for you as it is for me, but this is my review on it, and I've got to give you my personal feelings. All right, so first off the bat, let's introduce it. I'm not going to go through the usual unboxing and everything else like everybody else does. If you want to see that, you want to see how the menus and everything else works, I'll link to a couple of really good reviews on this down in the comments section down below that you can actually go to and look it over, one of which is done by a gentleman with a rather heavy Brooklynized Russian accent that when I happened to come across his video, I was like, oh my God, this guy is freaking cool. So kudos, bro. You'll know who you are when you see your name, your channel name and everything else down below. All right? This is the mod. Okay? It's the Eleaf iStick TC-100W. It is a temperature control box mod. It does nickel, titanium, stainless, canthal. It has a bypass mode in here, which means that basically this becomes a slightly protected mech mod for all intents and purposes, okay? Plus, it also has three custom TCR values in here, and I'll come to those in a few minutes. This is also firmware upgradable. Ooh, excuse me. However, yeah, Well, first off, the firmware upgrade takes this from a 100 watt temperature control box mod to a 120 watt temperature control box mod. Now, for those of you folks out there who like really super, or I should say super lava hot vapes, that's a good thing. This child, however, does not. I prefer my vapes a little on the cool side. I also prefer them to be flavorful. I'm not vaping magma. Okay, let's get that straight right off the bat. That's the reason why I use a Kayfun. Okay, clone or not, it's still a Kayfun. And as such, I like my flavor. I DIY my own juice, not only because I'm a cheap son of a bitch, but also because I like to control the flavor of the juice that I'm vaping. Yeah, 120 watts, no, thank you very much. One of the days when I was vaping this, I had it in my little holster that I keep on the side of my work clothes. And I was getting in and out of the car quite a bit, and I stopped for a minute or two, and I pulled it out, and I took one hit on it. Somehow, the seatbelt connector must have hit the up button on the power. I didn't notice. I took a vape. Luckily, it was on TC, because when I took that vape, let me tell you something. My eyes nearly popped out of my head. You know the old cartoons where the eyes go, wah! Well, guess what? That's what happened to me. Oh my God. Forget about it. It was never again. Never again. Okay, enough said. Yeah. If that had not been on temperature control, being at work and not having access to any rebuilding supplies with me, I am more than sure that I would have had not just a burnt wick, but the nastiest, vilest, meanest piece of garbage that you could ever think of. It was that bad. It will do 120 watts. And if it's 120 watts off TC, well, let's put it this way. You really don't want to go there. Unless, of course, you happen to be a masochist. I am not. Enough said? Good. Okay. I did, when I first got this thing, because this thing was firmware upgradable, and I wanted to get the latest and greatest temperature control algorithms in here, I did an upgrade on this to the 1.1 version of the firmware, which is the latest firmware version that's out there. Now, I don't know if it's me being a noob to temperature control. I know my build was good. I know my build was good. It was right where it was supposed to be. I had it at about a 0.8 ohm. I've also had it at 0.5, 0.6. I've tried it at 1.2, which is the maximum that this thing can handle under temperature control. Yeah, I've had it at quite a few different resistance levels. Well, suffice it to say, the temperature control algorithm that comes with the 1.1 for stainless steel, which is supposed to be tuned to a 316L stainless steel, and that's all I use. I don't use nickel. I don't use tungsten. Those things scare the living crap out of me. Okay? Since I've been vaping, I've become a lot more conscious of what I kind of put into me. Okay? So, yeah, like I said, those two metals scare the living hell out of me. The only thing I'm using right now is stainless steel and Canthal. Canthal A1. Now, the builds that I've been using, because I'm using stainless steel, I've been using a 3mm coil, inside diameter coil. I have been using anywhere between 5 and 8 wraps on my builds. The 5 wraps will give me 0.5 ohms. 6 wraps will give me about a 6.1 ohm resistance level. 7 will give me 0.9, and 8 will give me about a 1.1 to 1.2 ohm reading on there. The stainless steel setting on here with the 1.1 firmware does not work very well. I don't know why. It just doesn't. In order to get a decent vape where it doesn't turn around and constantly be going into temperature protection, and that was taking the temperature all the way up to as much as 500 degrees, I started at 410 and worked my way up to 500. 500 was like the best that it was, and the temperature at 500 was getting a little bit too hot for my mouth, so that's kind of where I stopped. I actually backed it down to about 480, and I kind of sort of got it to working pretty much where it was supposed to be, but not, I repeat, not on the inbuilt stainless steel setting. The only way I was able to get it to work at that 480 degrees was using the TCR or M1 TCR settings. Now, when you do the upgrade for this, the TCR settings on the M1, M2, and M3 settings are all set to 0120. Now, I have not been able to find out what those numbers actually, you know, what type of metal those numbers actually correlate to, but they do work. Once again, that's 0120. Okay? With those settings in the M1, M2, and M3 settings, TCR settings, I was able to get a very satisfying vape off of it at 480 watts. On the regular stainless steel, no. It was extremely anemic. The temperature control was kicking in all the time to the point where if I got a couple of tiny little wisps of vape coming out of my pie hole, I was lucky. So I was vaping it at that. I put that same coil onto the wattage mode, set it to 19 watts, and, well, let me put it to you this way. The vape cloud that I was getting was absolutely fan-freaking-tastic. I mean, I was like, this little Kayfun right here, this is what I'm, well, that's what I've been taking to work with me. Okay? Right there. I'll show you what it gives, does. Now, this is set right now at, well, it was set to 18. There we go. Somehow it got moved down to 17.5, but 18 watts. Let me see if I can get that. Come on, focus in. 18 watts. It is at a 0.7 ohm coil build. Now, this is what it does on wattage. 0.7, 18 watts. Yeah. And the flavor of my strawberry milk juice that I have in here. Let me tell you something. It's like biting into a fresh strawberry. I gotta turn down the nick level a little bit. Yeah, I got it at 6 right now. I think it may have to... I've been starting to cough a little bit too much at the 6 level, so I think I may have to go down to a 5 or even a 4 milligram. It's getting a bit much. But then again, when I'm at work, because of the way where I'm working and how I'm working, I may have to turn around and keep it at the 6 level for the simple reason I can't get out all the time to turn around and vape, and there's just no way you can vape in an office situation, so... I may have to just keep it at 6 level, but that's neither here nor there. That's what this thing is capable of giving me. On the stainless steel mode, this is kind of sort of what I was getting. And actually, less than that. I finally decided, after a lot of experimentation, to do a revert back to the 1.0 firmware. When I did that, the stainless steel setting for that is built into this thing, the one with marked SS, started working absolutely the way it should. There was very little, if any, difference between the stainless steel and the wattage mode. Now, the stainless steel mode was was cooler. I got the same amount of vape, but it was a little bit cooler. That was because the temperature control was setting in. It was actually a very satisfying vape for this child. The wattage mode actually started giving me a little bit too much of a throat hit. Go figure. I was actually enjoying the stainless steel mode. On the M1 setting with the 0.0120 setting, it was kind of sort of somewhere halfway between the wattage mode and the stainless steel mode. Not as much of a throat hit, not as uncomfortable as it was starting to get, and definitely the same amount of flavor from the juice as I was getting in stainless steel. Now, I've done this with two different types of juice that I've been playing with. One is a blue raspberry slush. It's actually not just blue raspberry in here. It's blue raspberry bilberry. It is an 80 VG 20 PG 6 milligram nick. All right, I made 60 milligrams of it because that's all I had in my flavor concentrates. Yes, I still have not yet gone and made a flavor order because, well, bills kind of come first, if you know what I mean. Not to mention the fact that this is the strawberry milk. This is also one of the ones that I made up. 67 milliliters. As you can see, it's an 80 VG 20 PG 6 milligram nick. Okay, and you can see that this is a pretty thick juice. Okay, you can see the ribboning on the side of the bottle as I swirl it around in there, and you can also see how thick this is. This is almost like syrup. Both of these had absolutely fantastic flavor. So that's one of the major things that I found wrong with this little baby. I also found that the screen brightness on this mod is not bright enough. In bright sunlight, when you're outside, this screen is dim enough that you cannot see it at all. The only way you can even start to make out some of the characters on the screen is if you're cupping it and you're in the shade and you're going like this. Then you can start to see something there and you can start to maybe make out what you're looking at. As opposed to, believe it or not, this little iStick 50, which is bright enough to be seen in bright day sunlight. Okay? Why? The 50's got a better screen on it than the 100 does. Don't know. Maybe this is because this is an OLED. I don't know. I'm not sure. Just telling you what I found. Also, the 510 connector on here. Okay? This is a short 510 connector. It is spring-loaded, which is a very good thing. I like that a lot. One of the reasons why I bought it was because it had a spring-loaded 510 connector, unlike the 50, which doesn't. Oh, excuse me. No, the 50 does. I'm sorry. My mistake. Unlike my Kanger sub-box, I should say, which does not have a spring-loaded 510 and drives me bloody buggers. Now, this here is a Kanger sub-tank mini. This 510 connector on here is approximately 8.5 millimeters long. I put this on here, if it'll screw on for me. And when I put this on, nice and tight, this is, if I can find myself a regular piece of paper. I got so much paper around here, it's not even funny. But I can't find the piece that I want. Now, I'm going to show you this. See that? That does not screw down to the point where that piece of paper is actually, I'm going to hold this up here so you can see it, fitting between the top of the mod and the bottom of the tank. Okay? Perfect example of a short 510 connector. Now, I'm going, juicy. I'm going to take my Kayfun. Now, this has a four and a half millimeters, something like that, 510 connector on here. It's considerably shorter by about 1.5 to 2 millimeters. Okay? Now, no fit. As you can see, I'm pushing that in. So, if you have a 510 connector on your tank, your dripper, etc., ad nauseum, that is relatively long, kind of that long, okay? Or if the 510 connector protrudes more than 0.5 millimeter to 1 millimeter from the bottom of the 510 connector, which you need if you're running it in mech mod mode, don't use it on this mod. Don't. Just don't. Because that tank will rock from side to side. Because the 510 connector inside here is not tightened down to anything. It slides into place into a couple of little brackets in there. If you watch the gentleman I was speaking of earlier, his video, he actually takes one of these apart and shows you exactly what's in there. Okay? This has become my go-to mod, and since I have very few of them, I'm not taking this thing apart. Mm-mm. Not happening. I don't want to avoid the warranty. Just saying. So, that's point number two. point number three. Excuse me. One, two, three. Yeah. One, two, three. Okay. I'm sorry. I got some notes down here that I'm referring to, because I want to make sure I get everything straight in my head and straight for you guys. Next point. Small screen. Okay. Now, I'm going to pop in a couple of batteries in here. Now, I'll tell you this right now. Do not use HG2s in this. They will not last. They will not last at all. Believe it or not, I know you're going to say this, that you don't, but these purple eFests, these things last longer than the HG2s. Okay? Just saying. These things here, I can get about 3/4 of a day out of one of these things. The HG2s, I can only get maybe, at best, half a day's worth of a decent of vape, period. And at that, maybe 1/4 to 1/3 of a day, decent vape. Use these. Sony VTC4s. The manual that comes with this mod highly suggests these batteries. It specifically suggests these batteries. I'm telling you, these things are great. I have, for the last 4 days now, taken it to work with one set of these, and I've got a set of my purple eFests in my bag as a backup just in case, but this set has lasted me a full 8 hours during my shift. Going out about maybe 10 or 15 minutes to the smoking shed, because that's the only place you can smoke on the property, and being out there and constantly pulling on it and getting clouds, bro, clouds coming from my Kayfun with this thing. Okay? Now, I am going to show you what I'm talking about by screen size. You see the size of that screen compared to the size of this box mod? Well, let me tell you something. That thing is small, especially if you're like me and you wear glasses. Now, add to that the fact that in bright sunlight, this thing is damn near impossible to see. Now you have a problem. Okay? Just saying. All right. Next thing that I found wrong with this. This. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. It's black on black. I'm going to try and angle the light here. That. The USB connector. Right. There. That USB connector is on the bottom. You can charge the batteries in this thing directly from that USB connector. Really good thing. I like that. The only problem is that you have to take your tank off and you have to lay this thing down on its side in order to be able to use that charge port. Not good. I usually like to take my mod and put it on the side of the bed with my charger in it. I have a special charger that I use. It goes up to 2 amps, but it self-regulates itself. And this will only charge up to 1 amp. So it will not overcharge, but I plug that thing in, I leave it by the side of my bed, so I can keep an eye on it. If anything happens, the schnozola will start picking up the smell of something going wrong. I know, it's happened to me before, so I'm fully confident in my abilities to detect something going wrong. All right? With that connector on the bottom, no. I sometimes get up in the middle of the night to go and use the head, and first thing I grab for is my glasses, the second thing I grab for is my vape, the third thing I grab for is my phone, so I don't have downtime, shall we say? If you have to take the tank off your mod, try sitting there and fiddling with putting on your tank while your bladder is screaming at you and grabbing the other stuff that you need, glasses, phone, etc., and screwing this thing on as you're stumbling for the bathroom. Not a good idea. If they had put it back here on the back, like they did with the iStick 50, hey, I'd be a happy camper. Real happy camper. Okay? One other thing I'm going to say. This is a production model. As you can see, this thing does not have anything on the bottom that says sample. I bought this from 101vape.com for, with shipping, $32.98. Really good price. Really good price. 101 Vape. Good price, guys. I like. Now, for that price, I would expect this mod, at whatever price, to not have magnets come popping off the body of the mod. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. That's the fireside. That magnet down there, for the longest period, kept popping off and kept being permanently, damn near permanently attached to the bottom magnet on the door every time I took this off. I glued that sucker back in using some cyanoacrylic glue, commonly referred to as crazy glue, and now I'm not having an issue. Okay? But coming right out of the box and only having it for less than 24 hours and having that magnet popping off on me every time I remove that door, no. I'm sorry, Eleaf. That is not an acceptable thing to be happening. May I suggest that you check to see the type of glue that you're using? Okay. One other thing I have to tell you is this is not really a con, but it could be. And it goes along with the dim screen and bright sunlight. When this thing comes out of the box, there is a plastic film that goes right along this plastic this plastic piece that's here that houses the display and the control buttons. Now, with that plastic piece on it, in bright sunlight, you can't even see it when you're cupping it. Be advised, if you should happen to decide to buy one of these mods, do in the corner, scrape, 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 just with your fingernail, and you'll see the plastic start to come off. Peel it off. It makes life so much easier to be able to see it when you go, oh yeah, that's what it's saying. Okay? Now, that pretty much covers the cons. The things that I like about this mod are as follows. I like the form factor. I really like the form factor. Yes, it is considerably larger than the 50. It's also considerably heavier than the 50. It is built like a freaking tank. I like that because I am ever so slightly a klutz. I admit it. I try not to be, but I am sometimes. This thing, why is this thing leaking all over the place? Oh, I know why. We're expecting rain today. Atmospheric pressure is going high. This thing's going to leak. Let me take a vape on this thing. DIY strawberry milk. Yum. Where was I? Oh, yeah. form factor. I really like the form factor. It is ergonomic to the nth degree. It is comfortable in your paw. It really is. The fact that you can flip this thing. Now, normally, I vape like this. Lefty. And with the screen in this orientation, it works great for me. If you happen to be a righty, you just flip the screen. In the off, plus and minus, flip, done. Okay? Really love it. I also love the fact that this is parallel 18650s. Series 18650 mods will give you a lot higher voltage so you can do some really funky stuff like building god-awful stupid low on your coils and being able to get god-awful amounts of wattage. But even with the 1.1 upgrade on this thing, you're only getting up to 120 watts. Why would you need series parallel 18, series 18650s? Mm-mm. Parallel 18650s are great in the fact that this thing draws evenly across both batteries, which means that the maximum capacity of the batteries together in here, comprising the battery pack, is roughly 4,200 milliamp hours. That is more than enough to get you through a day. This thing, which has two parallel 18650s in it, is actually 4,400 milliamp hours. I can get 2 days off of this without charging. I can get about a day and a half off of this, since this thing is in temperature control most of the times, and, well, the temperature control has a tendency of eating up a little bit more power than straight wattage mode. I love also this locking switch up here that locks the fire bar. I absolutely love it. When I first got it, as most of the other reviewers out there have stated, it was a bitch and a half to turn around and use. Damn near broke one of my nails. But after the first couple of times using it, it loosened up to the point where, as you can hear, it works fine with very little effort. It's also a positive, solid click and a positive, solid lock. So when I put this into my little vape pouch that I keep on my side and I'm walking around, I don't have to worry about this thing auto-firing. Okay? Period. Big safety concern. I really like that. I would love to see something like this being put onto every damn mod out there. Okay? Not just the five clicks to turn it on, five clicks to turn it off, because that turns around and puts a lot of wear and tear on your actual fire button. Okay? An actual separate switch. Click, 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 click. This thing doesn't fire. The interface on the menu system. It's a little wonky with the menu button and having to hold down the menu button and the power up or the power down to change your wattage, okay? Especially when you're trying to find the sweet spot with that brand new build that you just put on there. I'm sure it works the same with, it's going to be the same with nickel or titanium. Trying to find, especially if you change the number of wraps or if you change the inside diameter on your coil, trying to find that right wattage spot, a sweet spot to dial it in just right so you get that mwah type of vape. That's a pain in the ass. But barring that, okay, the menu interface is really good. I like it. I like it a lot. It's simple. It doesn't give you a lot of extra BS that you do not need. Okay? I would love that they would, if they would be able to put something in there to actually brighten the screen, but they don't have it in there. That would make the interface on the menu system just a little bit more of a pain in the ass, which you don't really need. All in all, the simplicity of the menu screen is quite good, and I find it very refreshing compared to some of the other screens out there. Next thing I find really good about this mod is the paint job. It is bloody durable. Okay, I have a couple of little scratches on here from making use. As you can see, you might be able to see it or you might not be able to see it. There is some little pitting going on the actual edge, the corner edge of the up here where it's starting to wear a little bit. But other than that, I have dropped this thing a couple of times on concrete. As you can see, there ain't no damage here. Okay? Yeah. And except for this shiny piece here, plastic piece in the middle that goes over the screen, this thing's not a fingerprint magnet. And take a bandana or a hanky, you get some e-juice on there, just go rub, 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 it's gone. You'll have more e-juice on your finger, in your actual fingerprints, than is on this thing. Because if you take a finger that doesn't have any juice on it and rub it over it, there ain't no juice on there. No fingerprints. Easy cleaning of juice off of it. Yeah. It's real good. All in all, given the cons that I have with this mod, none of which are deal breakers, I really, really like this mod. The cons that I have with it, I cannot give it an enthusiastic thumbs up recommendation to buy it. I really can't. The 510 connector, the 1.1 upgrade not working exactly the way it should on stainless steel, the short 510 connector, the dim screen in bright sunlight, okay? The magnet popping off, which is a little bit of bullshit, you know, dip, dip, little crazy glue, and it's back in there, but still. I cannot give it an enthusiastic double thumbs up. No, I can't do that. Can't do that. I can tell you that if I were to go out and buy this, if I would did not have this mod and I was looking for this to buy a mod again, I would still buy this mod, knowing now what I have found out about it. Why? It gives me a long battery life. It gives me temperature control. The temperature control on the 1.0 firmware works very well. Just saying, it works very well. I have had zero issues with this on the 1.1. Excuse me, the 1.0. My mistake, 1.0. All right. Now, I'm putting the Kayfun that you've seen me using on my 50. On here now. This, oh, let me make sure that's off there. Okay, I have this set for 450 watts. It's on stainless steel. The coil is coming in at 0.61 ohms. Let's see if the camera will focus in properly. There we go. 0.61 ohms. It's locked. 3.10 volts. Let's take a look. Yeah, This tastes better on the temperature control than it does on this in straight wattage mode. 450 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm going to lower this down now to 410. I'm going to vape on this here, and I want you to watch the screen. Now that's still a respectable clout. I'm going to put this back up to the 450. Watch the screen again. Okay, temperature control works on this. I love my tea. The temperature control works on this, and it works very well. Like I said earlier, even when I put this thing at 120 watts, it was in temperature control, and it totally by accident. Duh. I did not have a burnt wick on this thing. I had a very raw, sore throat, but I didn't have a burnt wick, okay? I'm not going to go into doing all the burnt wicks and stuff like that. We're already at 45 minutes here of me just mouthing off and giving you all this bullshit, which is not really bullshit, because what I found here is more important than giving you all the rest of the usual reviewer stuff where you turn around, you get to see the menus, blah, 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 blah. Okay. All in all, I will not, as I said before, I will not give this an enthusiastic two thumbs up. I will, however, give it a single thumbs up because of all of the issues, the minor niggling little issues that I've had with this thing. I still really like this, and I would still go out and purchase this mod yet again, even with all of the issues that I had with it. And I can say this totally sincerely and without any kind of equivocation. If you're looking for an inexpensive, inexpensive mod, that, well, yeah, it does have some fit and finish issues, but then again, most manufactured Chinese mods do have some fit and finish issues. It still looks good. Oh, sorry, I wanted to get that on camera. It looks good. It works good. As you can see, the size of the screen. Yeah, let me get that straight there. Yeah, by all means, go out and buy it. If the cons that I stated here in this review are not something that are going to be deal breakers for you, then by all means, go out and buy it. You will enjoy this mod. It will give you long life, especially if you're using VTC4s. Oh, sorry. I got an itch here. If you're using VTC4s, you will get a full day's worth of vape out of this thing. If you're, however, in one of those kind of situations where you can vape at any given second of any particular day, you might want to go out and see about getting yourself a battery case like this. Throw an extra set of VTC4s in it. Keep it in your pocket. Keep it in your go bag, whatever. And have the extra set there for you. Okay? Yes, I do say to you, this is a good mod. Okay, and I will recommend it one thumbs up with the provisos of what I found. Okay, that's all I've got. I will turn a little channel note here. I will be putting up, as a matter of fact, when I get through with this, I will be recording my review, kind of similar, in a similar format, but with a little bit of a twist difference. My review for the CeraVape Cerebus tank, and that will be going up in a day or so. I need to do a little bit of VT editing on this before I put it up. I need to insert some pictures. This video is going up as you see it, but with the introduction and the outro being tacked on, a couple of minor things, but as you're seeing this right now, this is the way I just recorded it. Okay, like I said, with the Cerebus, I have to put some pictures in there to turn around and show exactly what I'm talking about certain things. So, expect to see that up in the next day or so. I have to work tomorrow, so that's going to put a major kibosh on my video editing time. And, yeah, I was just looking outside because I heard that truck passing. I do apologize for the sounds, the street sounds and everything else. I live on a very heavily traveled thoroughfare here. And as such, the sounds are going to come in since the weather is absolutely beautiful and I'm enjoying a gorgeous breeze coming in through this window right now. So my apologies for that. With that, all of that, I will now take my leave of you. Thank you very much for joining me. I appreciate all of your support. I am still going to be running at the point where I reach 101 subs. And the reason why I'm doing it at 101 subs is because the very first sub that I put onto my channel was my sub, my non-channel sub. So in order to make sure that I have the 100 and that everybody gets a chance, I'm going to be putting it at 101. When I reach that 101 mark, I will be removing my own sub on there, leaving everybody else's on there. At which point, I will be running the drawing for the Limo 2, which I have sitting here over my shoulder. Yeah, right here. So, if you want to get yourself a hold of an authentic Limo 2, ooh, youch, tank down, it will have a build in it. I will turn around and put a build in here for you. I will include some stainless steel wire in here so you can make use of it either on temperature control or on regular wattage mode. I will include a pad of cotton in here so that way you can make use of it right off the bat. It will be wicked. I will personally wick this and send this out to the lucky winner at the from the drawing. Yes, it is used, but it is thoroughly clean and disinfected. Okay? I don't know too many bugs that can turn around and survive being in a bath of 91% rubbing alcohol for 2 days and still survive. If they can survive that, we're all in trouble. So, having said all of that, I want to once again thank you for coming. I want to urge each and every one of you out there, listen to my voice. If you are not a CASA member, if you are not a member of SAFADA, you're not a member of the VTA, you're not a member of the Vaping Militia, what the hell are you waiting for? With the FDA regulations that just came down last week, if you're not joining up, you are a slacker. These regulations will turn around and will kill off vaping if we do not, I repeat, we do not do anything to stop it. Get off your ass. Get over to CASA. Get over to SAFADA if you own a business. Get over to VTA. Get to the Vaping Militia and start supporting those guys who have been putting their asses on the line for you, me, and everyone else out there from the get-go. We need to kill these regulations the way they stand right now because they will kill us if we don't. Now is the time to fight and fight and fight yet again. They've slugged us in the face. We landed on our asses. Now we get up, dust our asses off, and hit them right in the throat with a karate chop. It's time to fight. If you don't fight, you don't deserve to vape. Go back to your smokes. Go back to your cigarettes. Go back to your cigars or whatever the hell you were smoking. Leave vapers alone. Go and die. Because that's what the FDA said to us. They didn't say, oh, go and do vaping. You'll survive. You'll enjoy your nick. No, they said, smoke and die or quit. One of the two. Now, if you want to continue vaping, you want to enjoy your creme brulees, your strawberry milks, whatever you decide that you want to vape on, get off your ass and help win this fight. I vape, I vote. If your congressmen, your senators, your federal representatives that you put out there to represent you don't represent you, they do not deserve your vote. Send them to the unemployment office with everybody else where they can get their weekly check, because that's what they freaking deserve. I'm sorry. I don't mean to sound threatening on this to you. I'm just fucking pissed. I am pissed that the government that I once swore to uphold and defend is usurping the Constitution on bullshit grounds. Okay? Enough said. With that, thank you for joining me. I love you all. Vape on, my brothers and sisters. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be ever at your back. God bless.